Frequently overlooked, authentic undergarments are a key part of your US GI ensemble. Most people wouldn't think much about what is worn under the uniform. However, period-correct undergarments are a great item not only to wear, but to display in your kit layout, helping to educate the public on even the most nitty-gritty of details on the US GI's uniform. Between the 1940s and now, men's underwear hasn't changed all that much throughout the years. In the civilian world, men would wear either knit briefs, woven boxer shorts, or something called a union suit, which is similar to standard long johns under their everyday clothing. Knit briefs were made out of ribbed cotton with an elastic waistband and were worn high on the waist. Most were legless, but a short leg option did exist. Usually paired with the knit briefs was a ribbed cotton undershirt to match. The Army, however, were not looking for these options as the cost for elastic materials were far too much to be issued for every serviceman. The Army would opt for a simple option of boxer shorts and plain tank tops. These could easily be produced quickly and cheaply in mass quantities. GI issued shorts, not referred to as boxers quite yet, were given to soldiers standard issue during the basic training. Originally, the shorts were issued in white, but while hanging out, they were prone to drawing unwanted attention. By 1943, the Army was starting to dye their undergarments in olive drab and khaki color instead. In addition to your issued shorts, you had your undershirt. Your undershirt was issued in an A-frame tank top style. Same as the GI issued shorts, we see the military producing them out of cheap and abundant materials like cotton. By 1943, we also see the undershirt color change from basic white to the OD shade. When the seasons changed and the colder temperatures became more regular, it was extremely commonplace to see soldiers utilizing their issued long johns. These were long-sleeve, skin-tight undershirts and pants that were intended to help insulate your body. These were made out of a half-and-half cotton and wool to try and get both the warmth wool provided and the comfort of cotton. Much like their warm weather counterparts, these started out in a white color until being changed to OD in 1943. If you've been in the World War II US GI reenactor community, you are already aware of the heavily debated topic of undershirts. You should try your absolute best to avoid modern white or OD t-shirts if you can help it. The overall cut of them is incorrect for the period, and these types of shirts were not standard issued to the Army. In particular, the OD t-shirt especially should be avoided, as there is no documentation of these shirts being issued to the Army. On the other hand, the US Marines were issued a specific light green t-shirt starting in 1944, being issued standard white t-shirts prior to this. While white t-shirts were seen on soldiers, it's encouraged to buy shirts that are the correct cut and fit of the 1940s. 1940s t-shirts used more of a boat neck style, which is wider than the crew neck that is seen in modern shirts, as well as shorter sleeves. However, it is highly recommended to simply use the tank top, as these would have been the most common undershirt seen. In terms of where to acquire these undergarments, you can always count on the big three: World War II Impressions, At the Front, and What Price Glory. World War II Impressions makes their undergarments in both early war specs and later war specs. They're also the only one of the three to offer reproduction long johns, although their stock is not always consistent and can be out for long periods. At the Front offers their tank tops and shorts in the OD shade. Both of these options also offer period correct white t-shirts. What Price Glory offers tank tops and shorts as well. However, they provide a different shading to the At the Front counterparts, which can be a great way to demonstrate the variety among the undergarments, as shading was not consistent with originals. With the popularity of these undergarments, they are not always available, and you are forced to wait for them to be restocked. If you are in a pinch and have an event coming up, purchasing some plain white tank tops and boxers are an acceptable stand-in for yourself until the proper reproductions come back in stock. Undergarments are for many the cherry on top for a basic GI impression. These pieces are for many the starting point into the finer details of one's impression and can help bring its quality to a much higher caliber. With that being said, we hope you enjoyed the video. Be sure to stay tuned for our future episodes.
And remember,
you're in the Army now, you're not behind the plow. You'll never get rich while digging a ditch, you're in the Army now. You're in the army now. You're in the army now. You'll never get rich on the salary which you get in the army now.